Hey guys, today I'm just gonna make a short description about brushes because a lot of people ask for them, and I just want to show you that this painting was made with only three brushes. Like, only I just used three, and I have a bunch of them which I don't really use in my paintings. So you can do it with just three brushes, and yeah, let's get started and show you what brushes I used. So the first one is a chalk brush, and it's really edgy. Like, I'm gonna show you an example of what it does, right? Like this. And you can just imagine it, right? You can just imagine this is like the pattern. When you just click, this is like the pattern it leaves. But as you can see, it's kind of this pattern, right? But I'm just gonna leave this here so you can just like this, so you can imagine what it does, right? And I'm gonna tell you the percentage I used these three brushes in, right? So I use this like 68% of the time of all the painting, right? So the painting took like I don't know, I'm not even sure how much the painting took, like 5-6 hours. Maybe 7, because I kind of enjoyed the painting and I was just testing stuff out and just playing around, and you know, but yeah, kind of like 6-7 hours at best, right? So this is like 68%. I don't know. It's, I don't know why I didn't put 65 or something. I just want to be more sophisticated. But no, really, this is an approximation of how much I use the brush, right? So this is like 68%, right? Out of all the paintings. So I used it in painting, I used it in the sketch. I actually made sketch with this brush, right? From start to finish, the sketch was made with this brush, right? So the next brush is quite similar to the first brush, but it's a little bit smoother, right? So as you can see, I have tons of brushes here that I actually don't use, and yeah, so the second brush is this one. So it's quite similar to the first one, right? As you can see, I'm gonna make a trace here just so you can see how it acts, right? And this is the printed leaves. This is a bit of chalk brush, right? It's edgy, it's very edgy, like the first one, see? But it's a little bit smoother, with a different texture, a smoother texture, right? It's just a bit more smoother, just for blending stuff in, and you know, I never use airbrushes to blend stuff in. So that's what I'm trying to show you here. Airbrushes, I use them very rarely, but not for things like blending colors or something like that. I use them for like effects, but I'm gonna talk about that later, right? So this is the other brush, right? And I use this like 28%. Yeah, it's like 28%, right? And this was like with blending, rendering, and making things more smoother, because with the first brush, it's kind of hard to actually paint the transition between two colors, or a light and shadow, or stuff like that. It's quite, I mean, it looked good, right? But it didn't look polished enough for the final version, right? So I used this to mix color properly, to make the transition better, so it looks smooth, clean, and crisp in the same time, because there are, of course, traces of the first brush in there, and I just wanted to make it a rough kind of, you know, like a rough painting, but without those finishing touches, you know? So I just wanted to give it that feeling, that edgy feeling, but smooth feeling in the same time, right? But not too smooth, okay? So yeah, and the final brush that I used, I swear I didn't touch any other brush. It's like this brush, right? The classic airbrush, and I use this like absolutely 4%, and I never used it for blending mode. on the skin or everything. I use it only for magic, like effects, like you know, color dodge effects for her eyes, like the glow in her eyes, a little bit of light in the background, right? But that's pretty much it, right? I didn't use it for anything else, like blending or you know, smoothen things up, or yeah, like soft lights of shadows on the portrait itself, right? To give it more black, or give it more light, or something like that. But things like this, right? Like light and special effects, and that's kind of it, right? So these are the only three brushes I used in this painting, and yeah, I mean, for people asking which brushes do you use, and these are kind of standard. If you can see, these are kind of standard brushes. Like the first one is a usual chalk brush. The second one is like I don't know, a texture brush, right? It's a texture brush, but it looks chalky, but it's a little bit smoother. So I don't know. You can find it in every pack. I actually found these two in most of the packs I downloaded over the years, right? I always found these two, right? So there, I mean, it's the chalk brush, right? You can even Google it and write chalk brush. You're just gonna find something similar, or even exactly this one. I don't know, you know. So these are the only three brushes I used in the painting. So you can pretty much do anything with a chalk brush, or I don't know, even the second brush. You can just do everything with one brush if you want, right? So yeah, just this description was just a pointer to make you understand that you can actually do things with any brush you want, right? You don't have to, oh shit, what brush is that? How do you use that brush? Oh my god, that effect is so nice. You know, okay, there are texture brushes that you can use in different paintings and all that, but I'm trying to show you that you can do anything with simple things, right? And even edgy things, you can blend things perfectly and make the skin smooth, the everything blend perfectly with just brushes, like very edgy, very powerful brushes, right? Like the chalk brush. So yeah, okay, that's the description. That's the mini description I wanted to show, to talk about, and to present the brushes. And yeah, okay, have fun with the painting, right? So enjoy.
Spark. Vlad.